Netizens, back with me again, Haji Gautama Putrada. I am your lecturer for Parallel and Distributed Systems course. This is a new meeting. This is our 10th meeting. In the 10th meeting, we are discussing about parallel programming design. And this is our first video. In the first video, we will discuss about design factors. Let's start our video. So we are still discussing about parallel systems. Where are we now? Let's do a little recap. So in the first meeting, which is in the 8th meeting, we talked about what is parallel systems, and we learned many things about parallel systems. We learned about Amdahl's law and Flynn's taxonomy and several else. And then in the next week, we learn the model paradigms. Again, we learned a lot. In this week, we learn things like distributed memory and shared memory, and the difference and the disadvantages of each models. And now in the third week, which is our 10th week in this course, we are going to learn about the system design. So this is how we design a parallel program. And next week, we are going to talk about how to program a parallel program. So let's start our discussion. So how do you design a parallel program? Here we can see there are 8 steps. These are one by one steps. So you have to go through these steps to create a parallel program. First, you have to understand the problem and the program. And then secondly, you have to understand how to partition the program. So a parallel program is absolutely about partitioning a program into several parts. And there are ways to partition a program. And the third part of the design is to understand if there is communication or if there are no communication in the program. And fourth is the synchronization. Do you need synchronization or do you don't need synchronization? And the fifth part is data dependencies. Is there any data dependency in your program or are there no data dependencies? And the sixth part is load balancing. So we are dividing our program into several parts. They need to be balancedly load, and that's what we are going to learn. And seventh is granularity, and eighth is I/O. And fortunately, you don't need to learn all of these. And there are some that are important, and there are some that are not. So the things that are important are 1 until 6. So we are going to learn about 1 until 6. And we are not going to learn about 7 and 8. So this we are going to learn. And bottom 2, we are not going to learn. But probably important, but not too important to create a parallel program. So let's go directly to the first step of designing a parallel program. Is first understanding the problem. And what do you do when you have a program? You ask one question. Understanding the problem is about asking one question, and the question is this program parallelable? I don't know if this is a word, parallelable, or so. Another way to put it is, am I able to parallel this program, or can this problem be parallelized. Can this problem be parallelized? So there are programs that can be parallelized and there are programs that cannot. And so we will discuss about how to find out if a program is able to be parallelized or not. In this video, we have successfully discussed the factors in designing a program. I'll meet you in the next video. Thank you for your attention.